What's up guys, welcome to our channel. In this video, I'm going to work on my Honda Civic. In previous video, I have installed Mustang style DRL sequential turn signal on the front. Now, I'm going to install same kind of stuff in the rear. So, as you can see, Civic comes with the reflector in the back. It's a simple reflector. I'm going to replace this boring stuff with something amazing. I'm going to replace those boring reflectors with these LED signals. I have bought this from eBay and it's not that expensive. And it's very easy to install. So I'm going to show you step by step how to install it on Honda Civic and how to wire it so it works properly. Before we start installing, we want to make sure this thing working properly, so we're going to test it. We don't want to spend our time removing bumper, removing rear lights, and then it don't work. So let's go ahead and I will show you how to test this thing. To test this, all you need is 12 volt battery. So basically, we're going to use our car battery. It's on the outside, so I'm going to use my Mustang battery and going to test it. To test it, there are three cables, black, red, and white. So I'm going to put black one on negative terminal and white one on positive and let's see what happens. Okay, it's illuminating as a red light. And now I'm going to put the red one on the positive. Okay, it's brighter. So it's working. But I think this is not sequential light. It's just a red light. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to connect the red one to the signal light. So it's going to blink. But it's not going to be sequential. It's just going to blink. This is second light. So I'm going to make sure this one also working. So I'm going to test this one. So it's working.
So our first step will be to removing the bumper. To remove the bumper, all you need is number 5 hex key. I'm going to use a rachet style hex key. Phillips screwdriver, same thing, rachet, or you can use the regular screwdriver. Clip removing tool, or you can use flathead screwdriver. So first, use the number 5 hex key, and we're going to remove this bolt right here. And second one on this side.
Now take a Phillips screwdriver and remove the bolts across the wheel well. Now take your Phillips screwdriver and remove this, this, and this bolt. Now we're going to remove same bolts on the other side. Now take your flathead screwdriver or clip removing tool
we're going to remove clips all around underneath the bumper.
So the clips we are going to remove is this one, another one right here, another one is right here, this one, another one, and then it keeps going around the bumper to the end of the bumper.
Now we're going to take another trim removing tool which have a small end, and we're going to pry down, put the tool in between the gap. We try to pry it down. Now we're going to do exactly same on the other side. Now the last thing is we have to pull out the bumper. So we're going to pull the bumper this way out. So you have to hold the bumper from here and then try to pull this way. So this side is loose now. And same thing on the other side. We're going to pull this way. Now the next step is to remove the lights. To do that, take your Phillips screwdriver and remove the two bolts right here on the both sides. Now, hold the light from here and we are going to pull out this way. And that's it. We're going to remove all the clip, that way we can put the light out on the side. Connect our light to the rear light of the car. So I'm going to show you which cable going to connect to which connector. To make it easy, I'm going to run these cables through underneath one of these connectors. Okay, so green connector is our signal cable, it's for left turn signal, and the blue one is a brake light. So what I'm going to do, the red cable is going to connect to the white cable of the green connector, and then white and black goes to the blue connector, white and black cable. Same color, white goes to white, black goes to black. So let's see my connections are working or not. When I unlock the car, our left signal and right signal going to turn on. So let's see. There you go, it's working. So finally our electrical connections are done. I'm going to put back our rear lights. Finally, we can go ahead and remove the old reflectors. To remove this old reflector, you have to remove two Phillips screws, one here, another one here. Now we're going to take our trim removing tool and pry out the clips from all corners. Actually comes out from the front and there is a bumper bracket in the back, so we cannot connect the new LED reflector from the back into the front. So there is only one way to connect it. Because it's already wired, I have to cut the wire, connect it from the front run the wire outside from somewhere and then repatch here. So if you want to do it, it's the best, connect this one to the bumper first and then do the wiring. Finally, I finished connecting the wires. I'll patch all the wires using the butt connector and it will work for me. But if you're going to install this light, please install it first on the bumper and then do the wiring at the light, and it will be the best way to do it. So now I'm going to put back the bumper, connect all the screws, all the clips, and that's it for us. We'll be right back. looks so much better, clean and nice. Look at the difference. Much better safety compared to this. This is only reflector. This one, people can see in the night. Like whenever you brake, if your light goes down, still you have a LED running. So if you guys have any questions regarding installing these lights, please let me know in the comment box. I will try to reply. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button to help our channel. And please hit the subscribe so you don't miss out our new content. And please share this video. See you next time.